It's time once again to get you on point. Let's get started. Welcome to On Point for December 10th. Hit that subscribe button to make sure that you don't miss anything going on in the county. With that out of the way, here's your Polk News beat. The city of Lakeland is another step closer to arming police with body cameras after approving the purchases of the device, but may not be in use until 2023. The $9.3 million price tag is lower than originally anticipated and includes more equipment as well. The 10-year contract with Axon Enterprises Incorporated will cost the city $938,000 per year and includes 250 body cameras, just four short of the 254 full-time officers, which includes 24 staff and administrators. Lakeland PD officials say the body cameras will be issued to officers at the end of 2022 or the beginning of 2023. The delay is due in part to a computer system rollout currently in effect. In the meantime, the police department will work on the body camera use policy by looking at other police agencies across the state. In addition to body cameras, other equipment in the Axon contract includes 250 new tasers, 165 new in-car video systems to replace current dashboard systems, and 10 new virtual reality training sets. Auburndale has a new mayor as of December 6th. Dorothea Taylor Bogert, the city's first female mayor, was sworn in last week by the city commission at their meeting. Unlike many other municipalities where a mayor is elected by voters, the Auburndale City Commission appoints a mayor and vice mayor from among the commissioners, and they typically take turns throughout their terms. Bogert, the District 2 commissioner, replaces former mayor Tim Pospickel, whose term has ended. $1.2 million of student debt has been wiped clean at Polk State College using funds signed into law by former President Trump and President Biden. On December 3rd, the college announced that it has canceled over $1 million of debt accrued by students during the COVID-19 pandemic. The debt forgiveness applies to students who were enrolled between March 1st, 2020 and June 30th, 2021. Polk State received nearly $18 million through Higher Education Emergency Relief Funds allocated in the CARES Act and a supplemental measure, and is using a portion of that to cover the cost of eliminating the debt. Polk State has also paid for students' tuition and fees for the fall 2021, spring 2022, and summer 2022 semesters. That's all of Polk County's top headlines this week. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and please follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Yeah.